Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV. Hereby we are going to learn and experience together. We are going to have our biology form 2, lesson 6, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on transport in plants, and the subtopic, the factors affecting the rate of transpiration. And as you are aware that we said that on our previous lesson that transpiration is the process by which plants, they lose water in form of water vapor to the atmosphere. Let us begin as we are going on with the lesson. First, we are going to have the lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, we should be able to state and explain factors affecting the rate of transpiration. You are aware, there are several factors which affect the rate of transpiration, whereby the factors can be either structural, structural. So in our lesson here, we are first going to deal with the structural factors affecting the rate of transpiration, but I would like that you catch up on all our lessons, either in the next lesson, because we are going also to capture other factors which affect the rate of transpiration. And as you can see, the first structural factor which affects the rate of transpiration is the cuticle. So the cuticle, we can explain it by saying that the plants which are growing in arid or semi-arid habitats have their leaves covered with a thick layer of cuticle. The cuticle is a waxy-proof, waterproof material. The cuticle reduces the rate of transpiration. This may be seen in plants such as the sisal, the cactus, and aloe vera. Plants growing in wet habitats have a problem of containing too much water in their tissues, such that such plants have no cuticle or have a thin layer of cuticle on their leaves. The thin cuticle allows high rates of transpiration as a means of getting rid of excess water. And as you can see from our diagram, that is what we are referring as a cuticle, whereby it is shiny. This is to prevent excessive water loss, especially in the plants which are growing in the arid areas, because they need to retain water. Our second structural factor we are seeing is the leaf size, whereby the leaf size in our diagram B, we can see these are the leaf sizes of the plants growing mostly in the arid and semi-arid areas. For example, the aloe vera and the cactus. The leaves, they are normally reduced in size, such that they reduce the rate of transpiration. We can also have our leaf A here, which is just got, it is very large. This means that it is growing in a well, in a place which is well endowed with water. So in the leaf size, we can say the rate of transpiration is high in plants with broad leaves. A broad leaf exposes a large surface area for water loss as compared to the plants with small and sometimes needle-like leaves, and in our case, the structures in B. Therefore, plants growing in habitats where water is scarce usually have leaves with small surface area to minimize the rate of transpiration, and the example is the plants that we are showing in our diagram B. The third structure that affects the rate of transpiration is the stomata. The stomata can affect the rate of transpiration either through the position it is in the leaf and the number and the size, its size. You can see, since transpiration takes place mainly through the stomata in leaf, their position in the leaf, also the number and the size of the aperture are very important as far as transpiration is concerned. Most land plants have or no stomata on the upper leaf surfaces, but have many on the lower surface. In desert plants, the number of stomata on the leaves is greatly reduced. Some have sunken stomata below the epidermis pits. Water vapor tends to accumulate in these pits, thus reducing transpiration. Many plants close their stomata if the rate of transpiration is higher than that of water uptake. Plants will close their stomata on a hot, dry, sunny day to lower the rate of transpiration. This phenomenon is known as midday closure, and it also helps the plants from wilting or drying up. Some desert plants have refers to tomato rhythm, which is closing stomata during the day and opening during the night when the atmosphere is cool. Such mechanism helps them to conserve water in their tissues. We are going to have our third structural factor which affects the rate of transpiration, whereby it is the airy leaves. Whereby, the, as you can see from our diagram, the leaves here are very airy. In some plants, leaves are covered with hairs. These hairs trap a layer of steel, moist air on the surface of the leaves, thus reducing the rate of transpiration. And the last structural factor that we are going to look at in our lesson is the glossy leaf surface. Glossy leaf surface, we can explain it in terms of the shiny surface. The glossy is relatively the same, we can mean it is shiny. So we can consider our diagram on our screen as we explain the glossy, whereby the glossy leaf surfaces reflect light landing on the leaf surface and also reduce the internal heating of the leaf and stomata opening, and hence reducing the rate of transpiration. So on the glossy part, we are saying that if it is glossy, it means that it is shining. So it will reduce the rate of transpiration by reflecting the amount of sunlight. Having done and said that, we are going to have the following activity, whereby you are required to give 5 structural factors affecting the rate of transpiration. And remember, our activity here is very specific structural factors, as we have seen in our lesson. For more information, you can refer to KNB, Secondary Biology Students Book 1, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And for more of these lessons, and this lesson, you can contact us by sending us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Twitter at Elimu_TV_Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels so that we shall enjoy more of this and more of biology lessons. Welcome.